An ancient Samoan civilization located in the village of Waitsoomuli in the district of Palauli on the big island of Savai in Samoa is where archaeologists and anthropologists have unearthed a hidden past.
What we found here is archaeological remains that are probably several hundred years old that nobody alive has ever seen used in their lifetimes.
This is going to open up a whole new area for the way people, the way Samoans, and the way foreigners look at the Fa Samoa and what Samoa is about.
Gregory Jackman is the lead archaeologist working at the Center of Samoan Studies at the National University of Samoa. He says the use of 3D LiDAR technology has enabled archaeologists to see what has laid hidden beneath the surface of the land here in Samoa for many centuries. An interesting discovery in Palauli is a star mound of Fetu Ma'a that measures just over 20 metres wide. Greg and his team still do not know what the star mound was used for.
The purpose for star mounds has been listed by some archaeologists as the pigeon snaring, and they do pigeon snaring in Tonga, but they don't have any star mounds in Tonga. Star mounds are very, very different in the Pacific because they're only found in Samoa. In this area, in the Palauli area, we found probably a dozen just on the LIDAR. In other areas where we've worked, such as in Alipata and the eastern coast of Upolu, we found over 80 star mounds by looking at the LIDAR. Behind us here, we have a walled walkway. The walled walkway is made up of two large walls. Some of these have been rebuilt, some of them have fallen down. It appears that the walls were at least a meter and a half tall. This walkway is only one of many that's in the area, and this particular walkway we've been able to see on aerial photos and on the LIDAR goes for several kilometers up into the bush.
An instrumental member of the Center of Samoan Studies is Dion Funuti, a Samoan anthropologist and PhD student whose case study is based on the Palauli heritage trails.
We've had lots and lots of interesting conversations about all the mysteries that we've encountered here, you know, and while we, you know, you feel like, wow, we've discovered these amazing things, we see them now, they're here, they're uncovered, they were hidden and they were forgotten, but it doesn't answer a lot of questions, it just generates more questions.
Dion believes working hand in hand with the village of Waitsoomuli has helped in the development of the Palauli project.
We've been working here for 4 years, and in working in Samoa, you can't just sort of drop in and take a bunch of information and, you know, expect people to give you all of their knowledge without working for it and without deserving it and building rapport.
Dion and the team at the National University of Samoa has helped to set up the Palauli Heritage Trails, and they've secured $50,000 in United Nations Development Project funding to set up the trails, a project that's in partnership with the village.
So soon, my 4 year, Tato University. Yeah, I miss 4 year, or yeah, for nine, my wife for nine, and so sailing.
Historian Leasi Olangi, Dr. Malama Malaysia, has dedicated much of his life to researching Samoan history. He believes LIDAR technology has revealed a past that is not only pivotal to Samoan history, but also offers insight into the origins of Polynesians and the people of the Pacific.
It's an important clue, if you like, that would help to explain Polynesia as a culture area, to an extent that it hasn't been done before.
The team involved who have helped to unearth Samoa's archaeological past and establish the Palauli Heritage Trails says what is found here is not an isolated case, but one that is seen throughout Samoa.
The archaeological remains that we're finding here, which are found all over Samoa, I think reflect not only what our ancestors developed once they arrived here in these lands, but also what they brought with them, the knowledge that they brought with them, the skill sets that they brought with them, and the ability to survive in a terrain like this. And I think that's also something they took along with them to wherever they went next, which I think speaks to the interconnectedness of Pacific people in general.
It's really a work of commitment. It's a work of love for culture and history. We are so devoted to it that whatever it takes, we would like the project to succeed, because it has a huge implications on the understanding of Samoan culture in the future.